God! No! God damn it. Okay, this is a basketball game. He's hurt. But this is a visual novel. This is probably about overcoming yourself. But being selfish, we're such a good team, like we all are friends and stuff like that. Kyo takes the last shot. Everything else would be not responsible.
Okay.
We scatter across the court. If this first pass gets stolen, it's game over. The other team knows that, so they're playing even harder defense than normal. The opposing formation switches around and around so quickly that I start to feel dizzy. I toss the ball inbounds. It reaches Kyo. She passes it back to me before she's surrounded. I dribble the ball and cut through the center. The other team acts like they've been taken by surprise. They were probably on the lookout for another one of Kyo's three-point shots. 1, 2, layup. I see a shadow pass across my vision. I move the ball across my chest and into my left hand. Then I leave the ball floating into the air, trusting that Sunohara is behind me. Sunohara's voice. I turn around to see Sunohara landing on the ground, the ball in his hands. Sunohara's defender quickly comes around to cover him. He fakes one way, then tosses the ball against the floor. It bounces high in the air. Kyo grabs it as she runs forward. She shakes off his defender, and then she shoots a three-pointer. The ball bounces above the hoop. It dances above the thin metal frame once, twice, three times, then falls to the curb without any contact with the net. Silence comes over the entire building.
Time up!
A voice announces our fate. Moments later, the basketball team is cheering with joy. Don't, Sunohara. They won, so they are allowed to say whatever they want. We lost. We should resign ourselves to the fact. The crowd quickly starts to scatter. I noticed a number of teachers heading our way, seemingly parting the crowd of students. They're probably the advisors for whatever club used the gym. Leading them is Ui, the guidance counselor. Sunohara sprints for the emergency access on the opposite side of the gym. See you later! Kyo follows after him. I can't sit around either. Nagisa, we're leaving too. And that's all? Come on. This is unfair. Like, how was I supposed to... Maybe it would have been also a loss if Tomoya did the last shot. But this is... It's irresponsible. It would have been really irresponsible. On the other hand, if this, like, gets me on a bad route, I'm really, really pissed. Like, if this gets me in the direction of a bad ending or something, because I lost a fucking basketball game, I'm going to be very angry. Ah, well, I don't know yet, so no reason to complain, but still, this seems like, this seemed a lot like, whoops, you fucked up, the other team won, well, what can you do? You know what I mean? Well, it was a big pain in the butt for me. What else is there? Okay, sure. Ain't youth wonderful? Though we did get taken out in the process. Okay, so the follow-up is on the next day. I guess that's okay.
Well,
It sure would be nice if that happened. I don't think we can say yet. Lunch break. I bring Nagisa to my classroom. Looks like he's not here yet. I say it as I look through the door towards Sunohara's seat. Whether he's still tired or not, though, I doubt he'll be around for a while. I doubt you'd understand. He's just in shock because of the loss, that's all. And that's why I said I doubt you'd understand. Yeah, you did. You need to at least try to begin to understand how his pride and vanity work. Yeah, so just forget about it. He'll come back after some time. That's all I'm trying to say. Well, I guess I shouldn't complain. If someone like you isn't worried about them, then no one will be. Don't decide how I should feel, will you? You never listen to what people say, do you? That's no reason to skip class, is it? I don't mind going to see him, but that just sounds like such a pain. Seriously? Hey, wait! I start to argue, but Nagisa runs off down the hallway before I can stop her. Well, I guess I shouldn't be surprised that she's concerned. She feels like we've just strengthened our bonds after all. I walk off after her. I decide to wait in front of the teacher's room. I stare at nothing in particular on the bulletin board. Speaking of which, wasn't the drama club information session supposed to be today? I suddenly remember. Well, I guess she's not worried about that kind of thing right now. Nagisa finds me and begins to walk over after coming out of the teacher's room. Sure. We start to walk off together. Nagisa brings the topic up herself, so she had noticed. Yeah, and even if they did, there's nothing we could do anyway. I try to soften the blow. Now come on, if we don't hurry, we won't be able to make it back by the time class starts. Nagisa picks up her pace, as if to shake off any regrets she has. Sunohara is asleep. Hey, give me some tea. I yank on his ear. It's me. Nothing, we just thought you'd be sulking, so we came to make you feel better. She falls to her knees by Sunohara's bedside. The loss seems to be weighing on him heavily. I guess this kind of reaction to us losing is natural, especially considering how much venom he spat at the Coral Club girls. He gets more worried about rumors than anyone I know. He's embarrassed.
それもあるけどさ。自分に似合わず頑張ってたからさ。それやり終えたらふぬけちゃったよ。そうでしたか。でもこれからも学校で楽しいこといっぱいあるはずです。一緒に過ごしていきましょう。気持ちはありがたいけどさ。 しばらくは抜けさせておいてくれよ。
Oh my god, does this group now really fall apart because I lost the fucking basketball game?
ダメです。
じゃあ、来週からは行くから。
本当ですか？
うん、行くよ。
じゃあ待ってます、トモヤ君と。
But personally, I'd prefer to be alone with Nagisa.
そんなこと言ってはダメです。それは…別にそういう時間も作りましょう。私も…そうしたいです。
やっぱり邪魔者！
いえ、そんなことないです。お待ちしていますので、絶対に来てください。
うん、わかったよ。
Nagisa, the time…
もう戻らないといけないです。
Nagisa finally stands up.
それでは、篠原さん、また…
うん。ありがとう、Nagisa ちゃん。来てくれて嬉しかったよ。
You're making it sound like you're about to die or something.
無実なこと言うなよ!
Come on, Nagisa. We need to hurry.
はい。
The long weekend seems to have given Sunohara enough time to feel better. Just as he promised.He starts coming to school as soon as the school week begins. Of course, he is tardy as ever.
Tomoya-kun, ohayou gozaimasu.
Did we make a jump in time? I feel at least like it. I mean, he said something about long weekend and stuff, so I guess we did. Yeah, morning. I can't avoid being sleepy since I go to bed so late.
早く寝てください。そうすれば寝起きも良くて。
Untrue, that is a myth. No matter how long I sleep, I'm always tired when I stand up.
朝からたくさんお話できます。
Or get up. Stand up is German. Or in English, stand up is comedy. But get up is correctly in English.
相槌打つだけじゃなくなります。
What exactly are you expecting me to do? I'm not the type that starts talking for no good reason, even if I'm wide awake.
いえ、午後からはトモヤ君、結構お話ししてくれます。朝は私が結構話しちゃってます。
It's not like I'm asking you to talk to me in the morning. And why do you need to try so hard to make conversation first thing in the morning anyway? You run out of energy for class.Don't waste your stamina before school even starts. She replies, then falls silent. We walk for a while, neither of us talking. Doing this makes the chatter from the students around us seem even louder and more annoying, especially when they sound like they're having fun. I had forgotten all this time, but I hate this kind of thing too. Nagisa pulls my sleeve lightly.What's wrong?
やっぱりお話ししたいです。相槌だけでもいいので聞いてほしいです。
This is not getting in a good direction. Sure. Funny coincidence, actually. I was just thinking the same thing.
本当ですか?
Yeah.
じゃあ、トモヤ君からもお話ししてほしいです。
I can't think of anything to talk about. Though I'm quiet for a while, Nagisa just sits there, waiting for me. Damn it. I'll just say whatever comes to mind. Who cares what it is? I look down at Nagisa and then... I love you. I say out loud. Wait, did I just really say that? Ah! I start to blush. Nagisa does the same.
ありがとうございます。私も…
I'm horribly embarrassed. You know, just yesterday there was a gigantic cockroach in my kitchen.
それは大変でしたね。
We both forced the conversation in the other direction. She must be feeling embarrassed too. Man, I hope things are not going in a bad way. I invested too much time into this relationship for that. After that, I talk on and on. You know, I heard that the more advertising a wig company does, Thus, to get its name out there, the warriors there are Wixar. Yeah, weak company and their huge problems. Yeah, so be careful. Hopefully you don't need too much of those. By the time we reach school, my throat is dry. I'm such an idiot. See you. I turn away from her and head to my classroom. Nagisa calls out for me to stop. I pause and look back around. Yeah. Sure. Go ahead, what is it? Yeah, funny that you say that. I was just thinking the same thing. Yeah. Well, it's your turn tomorrow. I start walking off again, leaving her with those words. The only thing I can hear behind me is Nagisa's energetic response. I raise a hand to say goodbye, then enter the classroom. I go to school with Nagisa, spend lunch with Nagisa, and leave school with Nagisa. We spend day after day like this. Sometimes I find it irritating, but others I can't help but think about how cute she is. That's the kind of life I now lead at school. It's peaceful. To think that I'd ever be spending time at school like this, it seems almost comical, if I do say so myself. The new student council is inaugurated over the weekend. Nagisa and I go to the student council room time and time again to talk with them directly. The topic of our conversation is, of course, the drama club. But in the end, we get nowhere. We really do need an advisor to do anything. Well, we shouldn't give up. Maybe another club will fold and an advisor will be freed up. There are other ways too. You never know. Something else surprising could happen that will give us a chance to reform the club. That's why you shouldn't give up hope. I keep on trying to encourage Nagisa. She groans for a moment. But in the end, Nagisa nods, showing the positivity that I've come to know her for. We spend Founders Festival, our equivalent to a school festival, together as well. But it's the last day that I spent at school with Nagisa. What? Is she okay, Sanae-san? I'm sorry. I must have made her run around too much. I got so excited, so I took her all over the place, and then... You knew about that? I'm a good-for-nothing boyfriend. Okay. Please do. Okay. I should be the one saying that. I still don't understand how she can like someone like me. I'm glad to hear that. I feel ashamed. All I did was play all day. Well, if you insist, then thank you. As for Nagisa, the day after Founders Festival, she's bedridden with a fever. Nagisa. I enter the room. It's hot with Nagisa's fever. As she lies in bed, Nagisa turns her face to look at me. Huh? What are you talking about? There's nothing we can do about that. It's not like it's your fault. I just told you this isn't true. Nagisa is acting more timid than usual, Maybe it's because of her illness. Ever since that day we met at the bottom of the hill, she's been trying so hard. Even though she couldn't reform the drama club in the end. Or could it be that at some point, the two of us ran from the rest of the world into the comforting weakness of thinking that the only thing that mattered was being together? I don't want that to be the case. I'm sure we looked reality in the eye when we worked as hard as we did. And that's not going to change from here on either. I didn't see it happen, but Nagisa's eyes are now closed, and she's sleeping. She's so defenseless. I put my hand to cheek and feel her warmth. I'm sure there are many more troubled times ahead of us. For both her and me. That's how I feel things will go. That's why we should consider this a short little break. That's all. I let go of her hand and stand up. I leave the room so as not to wake her. Whenever I had spare time, I would give Nagisa a sick visit. I had a lot of fun talking not only with Nagisa, but also with Sanae-san. Though as always, the old man was the only one I found hard to deal with. I passed by a customer in front of the store.
Okazaki-san?
She calls me to a stop. I look back to see a woman with short hair looking at me. Ibuki-san, was it?
Hi.
Where did I meet this woman? Oh, that's right. It was the day before our match with the basketball club. We had been inside the store, and Sanae-san had introduced her to me as Nagisa's former homeroom teacher. Well, kind of. Sanae-san and the rest are here too. You're not here for bread today, are you, Ibuki-san? That's what I say, after checking to see that she's got nothing in her hand. Huh? Are you going back home or something? Ah, so that's what it's about. You'll just be in the next town over. It's really not that far. Eh? I'm taken aback at the unexpected mention of that name. Yes. Yes. No, that would seriously be impossible. I'd probably just get a job. You know about us too? I ask in return, ignoring her question. Yeah, what about that?
それならもしかして岡崎さんとそのお友達の方が高村先生の最後の教え子になるんじゃないかと思ったんです。
His final students?
はい。高村先生、今年度で退職されるんです。
Really? I didn't know. But he was only my homeroom during my first year, not this one.
はい、知っていますよ。
It's fine, just say it.
Huh? In
that case, yeah. If it's two people he talked about, and it was probably me and Sunohara. Ibuki-san leans against the iron bar and starts talking. I knew the school she was talking about. It was an infamous school, containing all the town's delinquents. With that frail body of his? Guess so. Seriously? I can't believe it.
でもただ一つ貫いたことがあったんです。
What was that?
絶対に学校を辞めさせない、自主退学もさせなかったんです。高村先生は学校を人生の縮図だと考えていたんです。学校で過ごす3年間は勉強のためだけじゃない、人と接して友達を作って協力して。
Well, I guess he really was a very good teacher then. This is how teachers should be, you know. I mean, not the strict part. I mean, there are good strict teachers and bad strict teachers. It depends on the way you do it. But like, teaching the students what the world is like in the school, you know? Like working together, working hard and, you know, stuff like that.
成功もあったり、失敗もあったり、楽しいこともあったり、そして誰もが入学した当初に描いていた卒業という目標に向かって歩んでいく。それを途中で諦めたり、挫折しちゃったりしたら、人生に挫折したも同じ。その後に待つ、もっと大きな人生に立ち向かっていけるはずがない。だから生徒たちを叱るだけでなく、励ましながら共に歩んでいったんです。でも今の学校に来てからはその必要がなくなったんです。みんなが優秀なんです。きっと高村先生にとっての教育、自分の教員生活の中でなすべきこと、それを必要とされず、そして否定されてしまった6年間だったと思います。みんなあの学校で過ごす3年間は人生の一つのステップとしてしか考えてませんから、自分の役目だと思っていたことはここでは何一つ必要とされていない。それを感じ続けた6年間。
I wonder what all this exposition is about now, though.
そして、その教員生活もこの春終わってしまうんです。
Ibuki-san finishes her story and pulls away from the iron rod. She then faces my way.
岡崎さんはどう思いますか?
You really can't judge a book by its cover, huh? I tell her what came to mind.
そうですね。
When she hears me say that, Ibuki-san smiles.
聞いてんのか?
Hmm?
ほら、卒業前にでかいことやろうっての。ラグビー部の連中に一泡吹かせたいしさ。
Yeah... I wonder how many months it's been since I had that conversation with Ibuki-san. I still remember that conversation quite clearly. How had I answered back then? You really can't judge a book by its cover, huh? What am I? An idiot? In the end...We really were just children. We wouldn't have even graduated if it wasn't for him. Say, Sunohara.
Huh?
Do you remember the day we first met? I asked that as I lie down on the kotatsu.
Ah, 覚えてるよ。お前超インパクトあったもんな。
The one who had an impact was you, by the way, not me.
だっけか?
I mean, your face was all bruised and swollen.
Ah, 相手はその倍ボコボコだったけどね。
He'd probably be dead if he was worse off than you.
サッカー部の部員同士で喧嘩したんだよな。それで僕が生活指導室にいたら、お前もジジイに連れてこられたんだ。
What the fuck is going on with Nagisa? Was that implying that she died from a fever or something? Are we in the 17th century? I want to know what is going on with Nagisa. I mean, great if...Tomoya and Sunohara now decide that they actually should go to university and become useful members of society or whatever they decide. That's not really my concern right now, to be honest. Yeah, I bet that Komura was trying to introduce us.
引き合わせる? 誰と誰をさ?
You and me.
どうして?
How would things have gone if you'd been left alone after that?
何が?
I'm talking about you and this school.I'm asking how things would have gone if you'd been alone after that. Komura knew. He knew that if Sunohara and I had lived our school life separately, that we would end up quitting. That's why he introduced us. When winter arrived, we became busy job hunting. It was almost like the culmination of everything we'd done until now. Sonohara had returned home, hoping to find a job in his hometown. I also frequented the employment bureau at school, looking for a job. In the end, Sonohara didn't come back until the graduation ceremony. We spent our final hours together, having not even had the time to do anything crazy. We were in the front yard. The graduation ceremony was being held at the gymnasium. Sonohara and I had snuck out, not being able to stand sitting next to those guys. After just one more hour, we will have graduated, whether we want to or not. Our time in which to do as we please will be coming to an end. You know those guys will be graduating today too, right? That's a dumb question if I ever heard one. I'm sure they'll come party with you one last time if you call them, you know. Before I know it, Komura's standing in front of us. Yeah, I everyone in elementary school, that is. Yeah, over in your hometown. It's the opposite, really. We're acting like this exactly because these are our final moments. No, man. It's not like that will be necessary after today, though. I feel bad for our homeroom teacher. Komura heads back into the gymnasium. Hey, Grams? I call him to a stop. So apparently Nagisa is living. Okay, I was like already scared. Like, what the fuck? She never went back to school. Why did you have us graduate? He says without turning to face us. That's right. I'm sure he's been supporting us from the shadows even more than we could imagine. And I felt that even more than I do now. That I would keep noticing his support, even in the far future. That's what I feel from the bottom of my heart. I am who I am right now because of him. You know? I'm confident we'll be able to live a better life than even the hundreds of people here who are going to college. Though we'll probably go through so much more trouble because we didn't go to college. But I think we'll be able to do well despite that.
Gambarinasai.
Our final homeroom comes to an end. We leave the classroom alongside our fellow classmates. A huge crowd has formed in front of the school gates. They're all teachers and underclassmen. Next to me, Sonohara sticks out his tongue. The school gates are bursting with applause and people giving us their blessings. Juniors from the same club, advisors, homeroom teachers, they all wave to us. Komura is there too, standing a little ways off. Nobody goes to speak to him. He stands there alone, almost like a forgotten statue. Sonohara and I exchange glances. And then we both run over to the wizened teacher simultaneously and give him a deep bow. It was an act unprecedented in either of our lives, One that we wouldn't have done for any of our other superiors. And we both did it, here, for the first time. I should have said that too, sorry. It resounds into the bright blue sky. So loudly that, for a moment, it draws the crowd's attention. They were our words of gratitude for these last 3 years. See you, Grams. Take care. We burn his final smile as a teacher into our memory, and pass through the school gates. I wonder what that was all about, like we saw him so little. Maybe if we played the Nagisa route differently, we would have seen him more. I guess, otherwise the study... I mean, it was emotional and all, it was well written, I'm not saying anything bad about it, but it seemed so out of nowhere. We basically saw him like once. I'd actually had the opportunity of talking to Ibuki-san on the phone at one time. At that point, Ibuki-san had told me she wanted us to thank Komura-sensei. In those days, when he was in his prime, it was apparently difficult for students to show their gratitude to him. That's why she wanted us, the final students he had looked after, to give him those words. However, it's not like Ibuki-san had coerced the words out of us. We knew that there is no meaning to words of gratitude if they don't come naturally. We were his final students. Just those words had stayed with me, amazingly, lucidly. I wonder if we were really good enough for that. So this is what Ibuki-san said in the end. It must be quite the honor for you, since you're sure to remain in Komura-sensei's memory forever. His life will be calm and quiet from now on, and during those calm, quiet days, he'll suddenly remember his time as a teacher. And you will remember those two bad students that he pulled through graduation. Will he smile about it? Narrow those narrow eyes of his even more. So much that he can't even see anymore. Will he smile about it? And be able to cherish those memories? Will he smile about it? To the end of his long, long journey. Okay, music. I'm hearing music. What? Okay, now did Nagisa die or anything? And I did not get that. What? Oh man, I'm going to look this ending up as soon as I know what kind of ending that was. Did I just not get it when he wrote something, when he said like she closed her eyes or something? Did that mean that she died? Come on, I don't care who song is saying. Give me first the ending of the name, the name of the ending, and then I read through the credits. There is a me route? Wow, I hope she's older when they get together. Oh, there's so many people I actually don't know. Ah, amazing. Well, so I obviously fucked that up. I hope I did something wrong before the basketball game. If the basketball game threw me off the good ending or something, I'm going to explode internally. What one calls an implosion, but okay. So as far as I know, the after story is a separate game. So this won't come now, I guess. Visual arts key, thank you very much. Now maybe this ending has actually no name. And I just have to look up a walkthrough or something. Also, I have to pee really badly. So could we hurry up or something? The first light orb. The end of his long journey. Oh no, these are the achievement names. Okay, give me a second. I'll look up the ending now. I actually fucked up because I didn't take the last shot. This is so fucking stupid. This is so unfair. This is so fucking unfair. This is not a shonen manga. It's not like, and in the end, the crippled man overcomes himself and does the dunking. What the fuck? Don't show me the fucking opening. I don't even care right now. Also, I don't know, is Nagisa dead now? I forgot to look that up. What? Come on! Oh god, and I have to pee, I'm even more angry. Why? Like, come on, this was such an unfair ending.